Working with assemblies often involves hiding or isolating multiple components. For example, I can control select these four screws and the top cover assembly, right click, and I would have the option to either hide or isolate, depending on what I need to be visible. But having to repeatedly select multiple components can be a chore. Here's where selection sets can come in handy. Control select the components, right click, and go to create selection set to make them into a set or group. Upon clicking, a selection sets folder appears. Expand to see the newly created set. You can rename the set accordingly. When you hover over the selection set, the select option appears. Hovering over the select option actually pre-selects the components in the set. You can tell this from the components being highlighted in blue. At this point, you can right-click and choose to hide or isolate. To update the selection set, you need to pre-select all the components again. For example, if I want to change the selection set to only the four screws, I would control-select them and click on Update. From now on, when I hover over the select option, only the four screws get highlighted. Combining the use of selection sets with named views and section analysis can really speed up your workflow while working with components. For example, I might frequently need a close-up section view of one of the screws without looking at the bottom cover assembly. Let's zoom in and create a section view. Go to Inspect, Section Analysis. I shall select this face and adjust. The section view is now created and saved in the browser. I will adjust the viewing angle to my liking. To save this view, go to Named Views. Right click and click on New Named View. This will immediately save the current view. Let's rename this new view. Let's put the assembly back into its original display state. Click on the new named view and the view zooms in. Use the selection set to isolate the components and turn on section analysis.